Welcome to Tines. Let me show you how easy it is to get started. There are three key parts to building in Tines. Actions, here on the left, the storyboard in the middle, and the properties panel on the right. Actions are the building blocks of all automation in Tines. Using any combination of these action types, you can arrange the steps for any process that you want to automate. You have ways to ingest data with webhook, HTTP request, receive email, and send to story. Outputs, like send email and HTTP request. Data manipulation and analysis with AI and event transform, and controls with trigger. As well as actions, there are tools. These are elements that you can add to your story. You have page. These are web pages that end users can input to and view output from. Record, giving you a macro view of data points across all story runs. Case, for automating case management. Group, to better organize actions within a story. And note, so you can document and share information on your storyboard. If you aren't quite sure how to start, templates and our story library are here. Templates are pre-configured actions. So if you wanted to automatically send a Slack message to your team every time a user made a request, well, you can. And you don't have to build it from scratch. Just search for the task you need, configure it here, and it'll get to work. Our story library has tons of pre-built stories for you to take a look at. You'll see how other stories have been built, and there's a good chance you'll find a pre-built story here to help with your own build. You can easily import them into your tenant to get going, just like this. All stories are built by dragging actions onto the storyboard here and connecting them. Simply put, stories are a series of connected actions. As an action runs, it'll pass data to subsequent actions. We refer to these individual moments as events. When you drag an action onto the storyboard, you can always add a name and description in the properties panel. But depending on the action you've selected, the properties panel changes to reflect the options we have available for that action. The automatic event transform action is a good example of this. You now have this guidance option available. This lets you use natural language to tell us what you're trying to do, and then we take care of the rest. So you can configure your event transform action with the power of code without needing to understand how to write it. If you're unsure what specific properties should be, or you just need help understanding what to do next, you can use Workbench, a Tines-powered AI chat interface. You can use Workbench for general knowledge questions, sure. But when connected to your stories, Workbench can also take actions and access proprietary data in real time. Interact with it using natural language, or just choose a template here to get started with something familiar. You can start building right now. It's as easy as dragging and dropping an action. And if you get stuck, chat with us right here using the messenger. We're always here to help.